We're here at the Whitethorne Agroforestry Research and Demonstration Site, which is about 30 acres of about 1,800 acres of the Kentland Farm, which is owned by Virginia Tech and operated by the College of Ag and Life Sciences. Virginia Tech has owned and operated the Kentland Farm since the early 1990s. The Whitethorne Agroforestry Demonstration Research Site was established in the late 1990s to advance the component of agroforestry on the farm and to explore the opportunities related to the use of this practice, this land use, in the Ridge and Valley region of southwestern Virginia and beyond in the central Appalachia. So there are several different projects, different activities underway at the Whitethorne site. We have an extensive network of silvopasture paddocks using black walnut trees and honey locust trees, specifically focusing on the millwood variety with the honey locust, and looking at the relationships of those trees and ruminant behavior and forage development. We also have a resource allocation site exploring the productivity of those two tree species across an increasing slope, which is very typical for the landscape in this region. We also have some forest farming demonstration underway, focusing on ramps and a shiitake mushroom cultivation. And we have windbreak demonstrations as well.
I came to Virginia Tech in 2000, joined the faculty as an assistant professor at that time. And so one of the first research projects that we did here was looking at forage productivity under different densities of trees. Early in that development stage, when the trees were 7 or 8 years old, we had similar performance in the essentially open site and the high density site in terms of forage production. But out in the sort of intermediate shade or intermediate tree density site, we actually had greater forage productivity. So that was some of the first work, some of the first research work that we published out of this location. Later, I've had students do some different research work with sheep grazing in silvopasture systems. And what we have found at this point is that we can have comparable levels of animal productivity between different types of silvopasture systems and open pastures. So a number of things that we are still interested in doing from a research perspective.
So there's a whole host of different activities that are underway. And a big part of that is the kind of consistent research activities that have been underway at the Whitethorne site. This is a unique and valuable resource for the university. Students that take the agroforestry course are able to come out and use this as an outdoor laboratory to complete their curriculum assignments. Lots happening out here. It's a great resource and we're really privileged to have it.